Thank you, Father.
Here we are
to hear your word.
We hear it.
We receive it.
We believe it.
That we may be a doer of it.
You increase.
We decrease.
And we give you thanks.
Honor.
Glory.
Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name. Amen. Whew. One of the plans of the Lord is to continue to increase his glory, to take us from glory to glory, from faith to faith. And this morning, I was praying this for you, and it kind of jumped. Whew, so I want to flow with what I prayed for you. No, you didn't know I pray for you, huh? I do pray for you. And I prayed this often, but I prayed this morning for me and for you. Wow. And this is a prayer that the Lord hears and he answers. So turn your Bible to Colossians. Your Bible, I call it the Bible because I'm a foreigner. I am a foreigner. My citizenship is in heaven. I'm only passing through. I'm not of this world. You remember how they used to do the alien? We could just do this, but then when you do this, people, you think you're about to do an exorcism. Hallelujah. Are you there? Colossians chapter 1, verse 9. For this reason, we also, since the day we heard it, do not cease to pray for you. And this is what we pray for one another, and to ask that you may be filled with the knowledge of his will in all wisdom and spiritual understanding. And we also pray that you may walk worthy of the Lord, fully pleasing him, being fruitful in every good work and increasing in the knowledge of God. Strengthen with all might, autonomous power. Karamoshe, boom. Lord, fill them up with dynamite. According to his glorious power. And this is what zoomed on me this morning. For all patience and long suffering with joy, giving thanks to the Father who has qualified us to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints in the light. He has delivered us from the power of darkness and conveyed us or translated us into the kingdom of the Son of his love, in whom we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sin. Hallelujah. It says to be strengthened with all dynamis power. According to his glorious power, because we are filled with his glory, with everything that he is, everything that he has, and we grow from glory to glory. And as we do this, it says, for all patience and long suffering with joy. See, I have no problem praying and believing God for the dynamis power. But man, phew, patience? Not just patience, but patience and long suffering. And then not just patience and long-suffering, but then it says, with joy. I mean, really, God? I mean, seriously, God? I don't know about you, but often I have this conversation with the Lord when I pray for healing in your life and things to happen in your life, your children, your grandchildren. You know, the Lord already knows what you think. You know, you can't come to God and, you know, like, oh, Father, I'm standing here so patiently waiting on you. You can't when your heart is going, what's going on? What's the delay? What is up, God? What's taking you so long? So once in a while in my life, I come to God with just like it is. Like what's the hold up? Hello, God. Hello. Like, could you just send me an email and tell me what the delay is so I can have patience? God, I promise after you tell me why you're taking so long, I promise I'll have patience with joy because I know what you're doing. God, I tell you what. You don't have to tell me, tell somebody else to tell me. But seriously, God, I want to know what you're doing. And I want to know now. So thank you for giving me patience right now. Thank you, Lord. I've learned over the years that patience, of course, is a fruit of the Holy Spirit. Patience really means opomeneo, which means from the Greek word upo means under, and meneo means to abide. So to have patience really means to wait without worrying, to be able to remain under your circumstances no matter what they are, because you know you're not under, but you're over. To be patient means that you know not to wait on God, but you know how to giving him thanks for what he already has done. Because there's three different kinds of patience. There's patience for something. There's patience with people. Let's not talk about that. And there's patience in something. So if I think of patience for some things, that means many times people are waiting on God. They're waiting for God to do something. But here it says we do that by giving him thanks because of what he already has done. He already has given us all things that pertains to life and godliness. He has given us his spirit, and his spirit, the fruit of the spirit, is love, joy, it's gentleness, it's long-suffering. The Holy Spirit is here to help us walk, to have the ability to stand under without complaining. The Holy Spirit is telling us don't always wait on God and complaining because it doesn't work. Fast enough, or don't be the kind of child that's mad when God doesn't do something. You know, patience is really able to wait on your Father without being angry. The same way your children. Have you ever tried to tell your children some things, but they were so impatient? They didn't want to wait. They wanted to get ahead of you, and they were mad because you were not moving too quick. And children, you know what helps me is to know that my Father is patient with me. I can think of me being patient for something, but I cannot have the patience for what he has for me if I don't know that he is not in a hurry and he's patient regarding what pertains me. And the reason he's patient is because he sees the end from the beginning. That one is like the Deuteronomy one. It's the one that's hard to pronounce, but it says in Ecclesiastes chapter 7, verse 8, or 8, verse 7. I don't remember my numbers, but we're going to look it up. We're having a message on patience. That's funny. Oh, my God. Can we go watch a football game and pretend like we're not having this message? I'm kidding. This is a good word because the Lord is giving us 7-8. Oh, the Holy Ghost did it right. And it says what, men of God? Because I'm so drunk, I can't even find it. It says something about the end is better. The end of a thing is better than the beginning of a thing. I said the end of a thing is better than the beginning of the thing. And then it says that a man patient in spirit, it's better than a proud in spirit. Said the end of a thing is better than the beginning of a thing. Because if we believe in God, we do believe and we know that he works all things together for the good. We believe that he's in a good God and that we don't get uptight and delayed when there's a delay. We don't get upset. We know how to have patience because patience works in us, a perseverance, an ability to walk in things that we can't walk without him. In other words, Father sometimes takes longer because he sees what he has for you. And what he has for you, he doesn't want you to complain, because if you complain now before he gives you whatever, if you complain now before you get the thing, then when you get the thing, it will never be enough. Because if you have a complaining spirit, it's a prideful spirit. And no matter what Father does, it will never be good enough. So you will never be, we're talking about being patient for something. You can be patient for a mate. And then when the mate comes, after a short season, the first time that you realize that you get married to someone who really is a human being, then suddenly you crying out to God, God, why did you give me this mate? And the Holy Spirit then he says, you were impatient. I brought you, I answered your prayers. Now you have to be patient with the person I brought you. Patience is connected between being patient for something and being patient with people, because we all connected. We can be patient for whatever God's gonna do in our life, but we have no patience with people. We want God to change people instantly. We want God to get people to be perfect right now. We want God to get the people we love to walk according to our ways right now. We want God to really just transform people into the image that we like right now. We want God to lead people to do what we want them to do for us. Right now. We want God to have people to be kind with us right now. We don't want to wait on them to get their act together. Now we want God to have patience with us. Father, you know where I've been through, you know. Thank you, Father, for being patient. Father, I know I messed up again, but be merciful unto me. Can you wait a little bit longer? Thank you for taking me for glory to glory. Oh, I deserve your patience. I'm so So grateful that you didn't give up on me, oh God. Thank you. You're merciful. Your goodness, your mercy is following me all the days of my life. Thank you, Lord. Please have people be patient with me. I know I get mad at my grandchildren, but help them be patient with me. But the Lord says, listen, it's two ways. Two ways. Do as unto others what you would have them do unto you. The Lord says that you get impatient with others, but I cannot be a respecter of person and be patient with you and not with them. There's a place in God that it takes us by showing us everything that he has done already in our lives. To me personally, if God wouldn't do another thing, I am saved. I have eternal life. I believe in the inheritance of his glory. I believe that whatever he has for me, I don't have to know what it is. I know that my Father has the best for me, not just here, but even after. I'm not waiting for things. I'm waiting on the giver of all things, because of everything that he already has done in my life, I believe that he is, and I believe that my Father, he delights in showering me with his glory, with his love, with his peace, with everything that he has. He's my healer, he's my provider, he's my protector. He has done all things for me that I can have life and have it more abundantly. I'm not waiting for something to give him thanks and praise his name. I'm grateful. I'm thankful. I am so blessed by God. I am blessed and highly favored of the Most High God, because I was lost and now I am found. I had no hope, but now I have hope. I had nothing, but now I have everything. I was alone, and now I'm never alone. I had nothing before he had a hold of me, and now he's my everything. Now, no matter what, even if things disappoint me, even if people disappoint you, God can never disappoint you. We have a hope that abounds. God has done so much. In Romans, the end of a thing is better than the beginning of a thing. When I minister to people who say, well, God has not done this, and I'm waiting for God to do that, I try to lead them and guide them to remember what God already has done. Have you ever had somebody in your life that wasn't grateful? That every time you fell short, they were so quick to crucify you because you didn't do something right. You forget to pick up your towel still on the floor in the bathroom, and somebody just go off. I can't believe we've been married for 20 years and you still don't do what I told you to do. Can't believe the towel is still on the floor. Well, don't you remember, honey, I used to leave both of them. I picked one up. Thank you. Hallelujah. Can you have a little bit of patience with me? Because I don't know how to do what you expect me to do. I'm not you. I don't do things like you do. So can you just have a little bit of mercy? I have mercy with your nagging. I have mercy with you always, never having any patience with me. No matter what I do, it's not good enough. You know, when you deal with the spirit, no matter what you do, it's not good enough. Anytime you deal with the spirit, you know it's a spirit because it can't never be appeased. It only can be dealt in the spirit and teared down. Hallelujah. Did I read Romans? Oh, Jesus. In Romans chapter 5, it says in verse 1 through 5, it says, therefore, having been justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom also we have access by faith into this grace in which we stand and rejoice in hope of the glory of God. And not only that, but we also glory in tribulation, knowing that tribulation produces patience or perseverance, and patience character, and character hope. Now hope does not disappoint, because the love of God has been poured out into our hearts by the Holy Spirit who was given to us. Patience and long-suffering with joy. Joy unspeakable and full of glory. Father is standing where he is, and he sees the end from the beginning. He sees that your end is better than the beginning. He knows he's taking you from glory to glory. He knows that the latter glory will be greater than the former. He knows that he's producing in you the character of Christ, so that as he produces patience, then you can walk into perseverance. See, for me, long-term suffering is being able to stand under circumstances, to be patient in the midst of a thing. It means to be able not to go emotionally crazy. It's easy for the men. They're looking at me like, yes, tell them. But for us women, hallelujah. Then your husband is like, what's the big deal? I don't know where you get all uptight over nothing. But you know, the men of God, maybe they don't emotionally show it, but I'm telling you, the men of God, because they call to be the provider and to bring an answer to things, they actually would like to have an answer even quicker than you do. The car is broke, they want it fixed now. They don't even want to have the time to look in the manual. They want to know what's wrong with the car. They want to touch the car. They want to open the hood. They want to touch this, connect it to that, and it works. If it doesn't work, and the man of God has to take the time to figure out what it is, he will not sleep until the car works. So the difference is, the woman might get emotionally uptight, but the man of God will try to do something about it. So if you married, don't get after your husband, just let him do stuff. Say, honey, what you gonna do about it? This is a major key to counseling couple. What are you gonna do about it? Honey, I'll be right here crying. And you go do what you're called to do. Actually, honey, when you are there fixing the car, can you just bring me some cookies? And honey, can you bring me my favorite ice cream? You're such a good husband. Honey, if I fall asleep while you're working on it, don't wake me up, okay? I'll have my head under the pillow. Remember, the pastor says I'm emotionally. Remember, the pastor said you called to do this. No, I'm just. But in a way, it's true. But in the spirit, there's no male, no female. So what the scripture is telling us is you have to have patience and long-suffering with joy. And I'm telling you, without the Spirit of the Lord, there is no way you can walk in them. There's no way. With joy. I mean, just picture. I mean, wait without worrying. Honey, we don't have any money for rent. Makes me happy. Joy! Joy, joy! Joy, joy! Why are you so happy? Because we ain't got money for the rent. Patience until it comes. Long suffering, waiting under, because now it's almost the third of the month. No money. Honey, you get this. But if you don't have any honey, listen, I tell many couples, stop worrying and complaining. There's two of you. Do you know how many single people would really like to have somebody to worry with? Do you know how many single people would just like for once to have somebody nagging at them? Somebody to put their shoulder on and cry on their shoulder? Do you know how many single people, when someone is married, complain, they're looking at them like, hey. Patience. The reason is because it's easier when there's two of you to blame the other. The hold up is because he or she's taking so long. If he or she would get their act together, I've been telling him to get a better job for 15 years. Still doing the same. If he would have, he could have his own business right now. I've been telling her for 20 years to get a job. I don't see what's the big deal taking care of 6 children. I just don't get it. Patience with others is more difficult than patience for things. Patience in suffering is even greater. If you're waiting for healing on your body and you believe God is the healer, but the healing hasn't manifested yet, and in it, now, it might be okay to have long suffering, you know, for a month or two. Because, you know, 2 months is maybe 8 Sunday services. I believe he's my healer. for 2 months. Joy, joy, I am, how are you doing? I am healed. But after 2 months, oh God, can we be truthful today? After 3 months, 4 months, 5 months, and our body is still in pain, and we know He's the healer, and we have faith and we believe, because even when we go home to glory, it's the greatest healing. I mean, we believe so much that after you suffer for a couple of years, you're like, can I go? What are you waiting on, God? Can you just take me? Because I believe in the greater healing. But you know what happened is that when we wait upon God, we mount up with wings like eagles. You know what happened is that when we wait on the Lord, we find ourselves even in the midst of the long suffering, that the Holy Spirit gives us joy unspeakable, full of glory, that we even able to minister healing to others even while our own body is in pain. We able to believe that Jesus is the healer because we walk by faith and not by sight. And we able to believe we don't wait for the healing when we trust the healer. We believe and we wait in long suffering with patience in the midst of a situation, in the midst of things we're waiting on, whether it's healing, whether it's provision, whether it's something for an incredible thing the Lord is giving you. The more you look on what you're looking for, or the more you look in a situation in patience, or the more you wait for somebody, the more you focus on what's taking longer than it should, instead of what God already has done, the less patience you will be, you will have. It's like even if you look inside yourself and you know the transformation that God has done, but you know there's more to come, and you start just focusing on, well, I'm not walking in this yet, and I'm not walking in that yet, and I don't do that yet, and I don't do that yet. No, no, today I want us to throw away all the not yet. With ourselves, with others, we have to stop waiting for tomorrow, because today, right now, this day, how much do we have to be thankful for? How much today we didn't even know we would have today? How much things do you have in your life today? I see somebody that shouldn't be there because of a car accident. I see somebody else that death knocked at your door. And somebody else, you shouldn't even be there. And somebody else, I see that accident didn't get you. And I see somebody else that really, there's no way, no way that what He has done for you, you even expected Him to do. How much more? See, when the bad report knocks at our door and we hear that we're gonna have a sickness, we don't walk in impatience and start writing our will. Even though we have wisdom and we do have a will. But it's not because we hear a bad report that then we get so impatient. If God doesn't heal us today, we stop believing in healing. It's not because you're 60-something years old that you should stop believing God has a mate for you. Somebody laughed. But I know some couples who have met. And no, I didn't say you should wait until you're 60. Oh my God, I heard somebody think, did she say I have to wait until I'm 60 years old? Oh, Jesus, 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 I'm 51 years old. You mean I have to wait? And no, it's just an example. The Lord, I'm going down. The Lord, He doesn't want us to complain like the children of Israel. He doesn't want us to to be so impatient, and then we justify and find reason to tell God why he should hurry up. The Lord, I found long time ago, I can be in a hurry, but God isn't. God is not in a hurry. 1,000 years is like one day. And we like, I'm 51 years old, God. The Lord, he says today, trust me. Don't get angry in the waiting. Don't get impatient. Because I see the end from the beginning. Don't try to move in your own ways. Trust my way is better than your way. The Lord says, have more patience with yourself and with others. I have patience with you. I have long suffering with you. And when you were yet sinners, when you were yet sinners, when you were yet sinners, I sent my son to die for you. The Lord says, I didn't even wait for you. I already gave you the answer. The Lord says, today, by my spirit, I'm going to empower you. My spirit's going to give you the patience, the long suffering. But I hear the Lord says, I'm going to rekindle joy. 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 Can you picture somebody going to an emergency room and get a surgery with a big smile on their face? You picture someone getting laid off from their job and, you know, calling, going to some, praise the Lord, guess what?
Hallelujah, job.
I got laid off. Woo! Boom, 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 boom. Guess what? My mate left me.
Hallelujah.
Guess what? I'm single. Woo! Jesus. Guess what? I've been waiting for a financial breakthrough for I don't know how many years now. I stopped counting. But guess what? I'm provided for. Guess what? I'm still here. I've been waiting for my healing.
Yes.
But it's nothing like it used to be because I believe so much that I am here that I'm able to walk into things like never before.
Yes.
I have joy unspeakable, full of glory because of his presence, because of his glory.
Yes.
He's helping us from glory to glory. You're waiting for your husband. See, God tells us, speak things that are not as though they are. Instead of, you know, well, getting impatient with people, start doing the opposite. When you go home and you tell your husband, I'm so grateful that you love God and God loves you. I'm so grateful you picked up one towel. I've been waiting for this day all my life. So grateful you cooked the pasta, but honey, let's order pizza now. I'm so grateful. Start speaking things that are not as though they are. You're believing for financial breakthrough. Do you have a plan when the money comes? Do you have everything in writing of what you're going to do when your sheep come in? Your sheep, your chip, your boat. Come in. Do you have a plan? What bill are you going to pay first? Are you going to give to God?
Yes. Amen.
What are you going to do? Because the Lord, he knows our heart and he knows all that.
Yes,
right?
Yes.
Today we're praying for patience, and I think we should pray to have it right now.
Yes.
I'm just... like, Father, Father, give us patience right now that we can leave this place with patience and we never have to pray for it again. Next time you feel impatient with people, pray for patience.
Yes.
Lord, give me patience with these people. Lord, help me be patient with them. Lord, help me not get angry, patient. Lord, help me. Amen. Lift up your hands. Let's pray that right now. Say, Father,
help
us. According to your word, we believe that we can pray to be filled with the knowledge of your will, with spiritual wisdom and understanding. We pray that we may be strengthened with your dunamis power, with patience and long suffering, with joy, patience for all that you have for us, because of all you have done for us, patience with ourselves, with you, and with others. And patience in the tribulations, in the trials, that you may be glorified. We give you thanks. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.